الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، and continue with the pillars of muhasaba, the pillars of self-accountability. We said that the first one was أن تقايس بين نعمتك وجنايتك, is to compare the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you to how you have received those blessings with ingratitude and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number two, we said that number two was
giving rights and receiving rights, etiquette sometimes.
لك الحق وعليك الحق فأدي الحق الذي عليك وأسأل الله جل وعلا الحق الذي لك. That you have rights over people and people have rights over you. Give the people that have rights over you their rights and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for yours if they shortchange you in that. And number three, from the pillars of muhasaba, أن كل طاعة رضيت بها عن نفسك فهو عليك وكل ذنب عيرت أخاك به فهو لك. That every act of obedience, every act of obedience or worship that you perform, that you become pleased with for yourself, then it actually works against you and not for you. And every sin that you criticize or condemn your brother for, then it is actually the same sin that you commit. Number one is that every act of worship or every act of obedience that you perform, that you turn around and you look at and you say, I'm pleased with this and I've done this and I've completed this, then actually it works against you. Because in Islam, we are to refrain from al-ijab bi-nafsik, is to become amazed with yourself and become pleased with yourself and happy with the deeds that you have performed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلًا. Those who perform good deeds while their hearts are still trembling with fear, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لَا يَقْبَلْ مِنْكَ صَرْفًا وَلَا عَدْلًا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't accept any deed from you. No one is guaranteed that no matter how many good deeds that you perform, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is obligated to accept that deed from you. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Wallahi law kuntu a'lam anna Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqbal minni sajdatin wahida khayrun li min ad-dunya wa ma fiha. He said, Wallahi, if I had known that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accept from me one sajda, just one sajda, then it would be better for me than the dunya and everything in it. When we perform deeds, we are still in fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept it from us. No one has a guarantee from Allah that even after you finish your deed, that it is sufficient enough for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from you. And so when you perform your acts of worship and then you turn around and you say, well, you know, I made hajj, or I've given sadaqah, or I've given zakat. طيب وما يدريك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى لم يقبل منك. And what will make you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, perhaps He didn't accept any of it from you. So when we perform good deeds, we still live between fear and hope. بين الخوف والرجاء. بين الخوف أن الله لا يقبل منك شيء. والرجاء أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرحمك ويقبل منك. That we live between fear and hope. Fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't accept anything from you, and hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mercy. Because the fact of the matter is that none of us are going to enter into paradise simply based upon the deeds that we have performed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لَا يُدْخِلْ أَحَدُكُمْ عَمَلُهُ الْجَنَّةِ قَالُوا وَلَا أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ قَالَ وَلَا أَنَا إِلَّا أَنْ يَتَغَمَّدْنِي اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ. He said, none of you will enter into paradise solely based upon the good deeds that you have performed. They said, even you, O Messenger of Allah, he said, including me, even me. He said, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses me with His mercy. And the scholars, they said that there's no contradiction between this and the statements or the ayats from the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Udkhulu al-jannah bima kuntum ta'amaloon. Enter into paradise because of the deeds that you have done. There's no contradiction between this, because the strength that you've had to perform your righteous deeds, the ikhlas, the sincerity that you did the righteous deeds with, and the ability to carry out the righteous deed, all of that was due to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one will enter into paradise except by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, he said, "And to ayyira akhaka bidhanbin fahuwa lak," is to condemn or to blame your brother for a particular sin, then that sin, you also share in that sin. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Bihasbi imri'in min ash-sharri an yahqira akhahu muslim." It is sufficient for a Muslim to be considered a sinner and that he looks down or frowns upon his brother Muslim. That when we see a Muslim struggling with certain sins, we should not use this as an opportunity to define how religious or how righteous we are. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "La tudhira shamatata li akhik aw yu'afihi Allah wa yabtalik." That do not show happiness at the downfall of your brother. At least Allah will have mercy upon him and test you with what He tested him with. That when we see someone struggling with something, it is not an opportunity to define ourselves through their downfall. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man ayyara akhahu bidhanbin la yamut hatta ya'mala." That no one condemns his brother for a sin except that before you die, you will end up committing the same exact sin. The same exact sin. And Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned in a beautiful line of poetry, he said, "Waj'al liqalbika maqlatayni kilahuma baqiyatani min khashyati ar-rahmani walau sha'a rabbuka lakunta aydan mithlahum falquruba bayna asabi ar-rahmani." La ilaha illallah. That when you look at people who sin, you should look at them with the eye of mercy. Because if Allah had willed, He could have tested you with what He tested them with. For indeed, the hearts of the children of Adam are in between the two fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُقَلِّبُهَا كَيْفَ يَشَاء. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to supplicate, اللهم يا مقلب الكلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مصرف الكلوب صرف قلوبنا إلى طاعتك. O Allah, the changer of the hearts, make my heart firm upon your deen. O Allah, the changer of the hearts, make my heart firm upon obedience to you. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. وسبحانك ربك رب العزة عما يصفون. والسلام على المرسلين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.